Hello and welcome to this video on liver function tests. So this is part of a whole series of videos where we look at all the blood tests from all your different organ systems. So if you want to find out about other ones, check out the playlists. As always, this is just an informative video. If you've had a blood test and your liver function results are all over the place, maybe go see your doctor. Okay, now let's get on with it. Your liver is an amazing organ that's about here. It's fantastic. It constantly makes things and it constantly gets rid of things. It's working 24/7 and it might be the most amazing organ in your body, depending on who you talk to. When we do your liver function tests, we're looking at your bilirubin, your ALT, your gamma GT, and your ALP. Bilirubin is a breakdown product from your red blood cells after they've been processed through the liver. So there are two types of bilirubin. We're not going to go into too much detail here, but if your bilirubin levels go up, it could mean that you have some kind of anemia where your red blood cells are breaking down a lot, but it could also mean that you have problems with your gallbladder. Your gallbladder is just here underneath your liver as well. And sometimes, especially when people get a bit older, they can get some crampy pain when they eat some food, and that means there's a blockage in bile ducts and things like that, which can make your bilirubin levels go up. Another common cause for high bilirubin, though, is something called Gilbert syndrome or Gilbert syndrome, depending on who you talk to. That is an inherited condition and it rarely causes any major problems. So sometimes people's bilirubin is a little bit high, but it's not a problem. ALT is an enzyme that's found in the liver primarily. It's also found in the muscles, the heart, and the kidneys, but it's mainly in the liver. And when your liver gets damaged, it releases ALT into the bloodstream. So when your ALT goes up, it's an indication that there might be a bit of damage going on in the liver. Now, low-grade ALT can go up with things simple as an infection or some kind of drugs or alcohol, things like that. But when the levels go really, really, really high, that probably means you have hepatitis, which is a viral disease affecting the liver itself. So slight raises are something which we can look at, and you kind of trend them over time, and it gives us an idea of damage to the liver. Now, one very common cause of damage to the liver for a lot of people in the Western world as we get older is fatty liver disease, where fat deposits start placing down in the liver and your liver function goes slightly off over time because you are damaging your liver with all these fatty deposits. Now, you can kind of make that better through diet and exercise. So it's a really nice marker for things to work on over time if it's just slightly up and you want to see it come down. Now onto GGT or gamma GT. This is another enzyme from the liver, and again, it goes up when there's damage to the liver itself. Sometimes it's because of drugs or alcohol, but sometimes it's just infection as well. It is a non-specific marker, but it can give us an idea about what might be causing your liver markers to go off a little bit, especially when we talk to you about what's going on in your life. So for example, just like ALT, something like fatty liver disease, or maybe if you drink a lot of alcohol, these enzymes both go up. It can give you a good idea of the fact that maybe you need to modify your lifestyle a bit to improve your long-term health. And finally, ALP. So this is another enzyme. It's found in a great deal of quantities in the liver, but also in the bone. If there's a liver problem, it would go up, but we'd also expect to see the ALT and the gamma GT probably go up as well. That's telling us that there's probably a problem in the liver. Sometimes ALP will be high, but your ALT and your gamma GT might be normal, which might make us think that there's a problem in the bones. So it helps us differentiate and it helps us figure out what might be causing you to feel a little bit sick. So that's your liver function, one of the most amazing organs in your body that we can monitor over time through these blood tests. It helps us look at your liver, it helps us look at your gallbladder, and it can help us look at your bones as well. It's a fantastic organ, and as we've seen, it can shed light on things like fatty liver disease or perhaps drinking too much alcohol, which if you think applies to you, are very simple things to modify in your lifestyle going forwards. So I hope that's informative. Stick with us. Next, we're going to talk about your cholesterol status. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. It really, really helps. If you want to go into a bit more depth, just go to my website here, and you can also follow me on Instagram and ask any questions you like there. Thank you.